Welcome back to stage one of this mini project where you're going to be creating a simple site-to-site VPN. So at this point, your stack should have moved into a create complete state, and that means all of the infrastructure is created and ready to go for this mini project. Now at this point, we're going to be performing the first step of configuration, which is this. So we're going to be implementing the AWS side of the VPN configuration. So this means creating a customer gateway object which represents this on-premises router. It means creating a virtual private gateway on the AWS side and attaching this to the AWS VPC. The virtual private gateway, remember, is the termination point for the VPN and the routing object which is attached to a VPC. So we need to create this virtual private gateway and attach it to the AWS VPC. And once we've done that, we'll create a site-to-site VPN connection between this virtual private gateway and the on-premises router, and this is going to create two VPN endpoints, each in different availability zones, which we can connect to in stage two of this mini project. So let's go ahead and get started, and to do that we're going to move back to the AWS console. Now the first thing you're going to need is the external IP address of the customer router. So this is the pfSense firewall appliance that we're running within the on-premises environment. Now because this is simulated, this forms part of this one-click deployment which you've just applied. So to get that IP address, click on the Outputs tab on the S2S VPN stack, and next to on-premises router IP, it will list your public IP version 4 address for the on-premises router. So go ahead and copy that into your clipboard and keep it somewhere safe in case you need it further through the mini project. Now once you've got that, go ahead and right click on the VPC favorite at the top and open that in a new tab, because we're going to perform the rest of this part of the configuration within the VPC console. Now first we'll be creating a customer gateway which represents our on-premises firewall. So scroll down on the menu on the left, and under Virtual Private Network VPN, go ahead and click on Customer Gateways. Then click on Create Customer Gateway, and then paste in the IP address of the customer router, which should still be in your clipboard, under IP address. And just bear in mind, yours will be different than mine, so make sure you're using your IP address in the outputs of your CloudFormation stack. Now under the name tag, we're going to use A4L-on-prem-router, so just go ahead and enter that. Because this is a simple site-to-site VPN, we're not going to be using BGP or certificate authentications, so we're going to leave the rest of these as default, scroll down and click on Create Customer Gateway. Next, scroll down again, and under Virtual Private Network, click on Virtual Private Gateways. Remember, this is the network router object, the VPN endpoint that gets created and attached to a VPC. So we're going to go ahead and create one of these, so click on Create Virtual Private Gateway. For name, we're going to use AWS VGW for Virtual Private Gateway. We won't be using BGP, this is a static, simple site-to-site VPN, so you can ignore the autonomous system number or ASN configuration, and then just go ahead and click on Create Virtual Private Gateway. Once this is created, you can select it, click on Actions, and then Attach to VPC. Now in the Available VPCs dropdown, just click and select A4L-AWS, because this is going to attach this to the AWS VPC. Once you've done that, go ahead and click Attach to VPC. So now we've created and attached the virtual private gateway, and we've created the customer gateway object, which represents our on-premises firewall or on-premises VPN endpoint. So the next step is to create the site-to-site VPN connection between AWS and the on-premises environment. Now just note at this point, this won't successfully connect because there's still configuration we need to do on the on-premises side, and that will occur in the next stage of this mini project. For now, we're just creating the AWS side, which will create the VPN endpoints. So to do that, again, scroll down on the menu on the left, and click Site-to-Site VPN Connections, and then click Create VPN Connection. Now we're going to call this AWS-Site-to-Site VPN. Under Target Gateway Type, I want you to make sure Virtual Private Gateway is selected, because this is the AWS side network endpoint type that we're going to be using. Then scroll down, click in the Virtual Private Gateway dropdown and select AWS VGW. This is the Virtual Private Gateway that you just created and attached to the VPC. Under Customer Gateway, we've already created a Customer Gateway object, so make sure Existing is selected. Click in the Customer Gateway ID box and select A4L-on-prem router. So this is going to make sure that this site-to-site VPN connection is between this virtual private gateway and our on-premises router. Now, under routing options, we've got two choices. We can create a dynamic VPN, which requires BGP, and we're not going to be using that in this simple site-to-site VPN mini project. Instead, we're going to use static routing. So make sure the static routing options checkbox is selected. Now, in this static IP prefixes box, we need to provide the network range that's used for our on-premises environment. And we're going to be using 192.168.8.0/21. So this is the range that's used within our simulated on-premises environment. Now, if we're using a dynamic or BGP site-to-site VPN, then AWS and our on-premises router would automatically exchange this routing information. Because this is a static VPN, we need to provide this information statically within the configuration for this site-to-site VPN connection, and that's what we've done by entering this IP range. And again, this is used within our simulated on-premises environment. Once we've done that, we can leave everything else as default, scroll down to the bottom, and create the VPN connection. Now, we've successfully created the site-to-site VPN connection, but it's still in a pending state. And to continue with the next stage of this mini project, we need it to finish creating. At this point, though, what we can do is download the configuration for this site-to-site VPN connection, because we'll be using this to configure the pfSense router in the next stage of this mini project. So select the site-to-site VPN connection and click on Download Configuration. Now, if you click in the vendor dropdown, there are various different vendors where AWS allow you to download pre-configured configuration files. There's even a generic one if you don't have one of the vendors listed. Luckily, though, we do. If we scroll down, we can select pfSense, because that's the type of VPN endpoint that we have running within our simulated on-premises environment. So click on pfSense. Make sure the platform is also set to pfSense. Make sure the software is set to this or above. If I click in this box at the time of creating this mini project, I only have the one. You may have multiple options. You may even have later versions, but just make sure that it's 2.2.5 or above. And then under the Ike version, if I click, I only have the one option. You may have multiple, but just make sure that you set it to IKE V1. So this is version 1 of Ike. Once you've done that, go ahead and click on Download, and this will download the configuration for the site-to-site VPN connection in a format that contains step-by-step instructions to configure a pfSense appliance. Now, in our case, we're actually going to configure the pfSense router manually, but this file does contain all of the information that you'll need to perform that configuration. Now, again, at this point, we need this state to move away from pending before we continue, so this seems like a good step to finish this stage of the mini project. As a reminder, this is the architecture that you've implemented in this stage of the mini project. So you've configured the AWS side virtual private gateway, the customer gateway object, and you've created a site-to-site VPN connection between these two, which has created the two VPN endpoints in different availability zones. In the next stage of this mini project, you're going to be configuring the pfSense router, which is running within the simulated on-premises environment. But at this point, that's everything you need to do in this stage of the mini project. So go ahead and complete this video. And when you're ready, I'll look forward to you joining me in the next stage.